Progenitor bonuses are a significant chunk of the damage available on Kuva and Tenet weaponry. It will account for up to 37.5% of the base damage entirely, affecting the damage types and distribution you can use in your builds. While it is certainly possible to get duplicates of each weapon to cover every bonus, most of us don't have the time for that. Instead, I'll show you the best all-round progenitor choice for each weapon, to give you the best balance of power and flexibility. I'm Nick Engineer, let's solve a practical problem. To appreciate how progenitor bonuses work fully, you should understand the H-set system, which I've covered in a previous video. This is important to understand so you can figure out which elemental combinations are available to you with any given progenitor element and weapon. Progenitor bonuses cover all four basic elements, as well as impact, magnetic, and radiation. Which bonus you get is either determined by the Warframe used to start the Kuva Lich or Sister journey, or in the case of the Tenet melees, it's just what Hergoglast was selling that day. The values range from 25% to 60% and are treated like part of the base damage of the weapon in most cases. The right pick of an element for an all-round approach then depends on what else the weapon comes with innately, what mods it has access to, and what stats it relies upon to be usable in battle. If you are at all familiar with the well-established elemental meta of Warframe, it'll be no surprise that Viral, Toxin, and Corrosive are among the very strongest damage types in the game. Viral procs enhance all health damage, Toxin bypasses shields entirely, and Corrosive is a menace to ferrite armor, which pops up in a number of crucial places. To best facilitate this, most weapons will work best with a Toxin progenitor. This allows for no mod Toxin, or one mod Viral or Corrosive, leaving the other slots open for focusing on building up and applying the damage you intend to bring. In fact, Toxin is such a powerful and flexible element that of all the Tenet and Kuva weapons that exist, I would only suggest using something else for just three of them. For most primary weapons, the Toxin progenitor allows for easy Viral to stack with Hunter munitions. The vast majority of Tenet and Kuva primaries have high critical stats to make full use of Hunter munitions. Or in the case of the Kuva Shaka, it has forced impact procs which can make use of the internal bleeding mod. Viral procs are the only status proc which enhances slash proc damage, so it's an easy pickup. If you're against the corpus and want to instead bypass shield gating, a Toxin progenitor allows for pure Toxin builds on most weapons with ease. Likewise, against status resistant, viral immune, or generally ferrite armored enemies, the Toxin progenitor can be combined with a single electric mod to get corrosive. For most secondaries, they'll usually work best with a heat viral setup against any faction, which can be achieved with any of heat, cold, or Toxin progenitors. That said, Toxin once again leaves open the options of pure Toxin or corrosive builds. Heat and cold progenitors overall have poorer options to mod into. Let's face it, no one needs more blast on their weapons. Even when working with just a heat viral setup, you don't need to worry about trying to weight too heavily towards heat to get the most out of that setup, as primed heated charge is a thing, eclipsing the damage bonus of other elemental mods. And then with the melee weapons, Toxin is once again a solid choice. Again, you only need a single elemental mod, your choice of cold, Toxin, or electric, to be fully set up for your choice of faction, leaving the other 7 mod slots open to fit in those powerful melee mods we're all so used to, such as Blood Rush and Weeping Wounds. So what are the exceptions then? When is it better to not go for the same old Toxin approach? For the Tenet weapons, there's only one in which I'd break away, and that is with the Tenet Flux Rifle. This weapon is one of very few which has good damage, fire rate, status, and slash proportion. Add on the Flux Overdrive mod, and this weapon just churns out status procs. So much so, that elemental distribution isn't really a concern. In this case, I'd actually suggest adding heat into the mix as a progenitor element. This means you'd only need 2 elemental mods for heat viral instead of the usual 3, without any H-set issues. The extra damage type will mean more damage through galvanized aptitude, as well as the standard effect of the heat procs. Another exception to the Toxin rule is the Kuva Ogress. It's a primary weapon with abysmal critical stats and no forced impact, meaning it cannot make use of the converted slash mods. Instead, it has particularly high base damage, incredible range, and the Ogre-specific mod Nightwatch Napalm. Nightwatch Napalm in itself doesn't offer a lot of damage, but it does an excellent job of maintaining heat procs once already applied, and pre-stripping the armor of new enemies in the area. For such a fiery-focused weapon, with slots to spare as it's not building for critical hits, a heat progenitor is a good idea to increase the frequency of those damaging heat procs. This builds on the strength of the weapon as an excessive heat delivery system. Just remember to turn your energy color down. Finally then is the Kuva Nucor. This weapon needs no introduction. Even if you're new to the game, you've probably seen many people use it or talk about it. The Nucor again has no real potential for slash, and that includes using an impact progenitor and the hemorrhage mod, the slash output is still bad. Instead, it excels at status spreading, as well as damage dealing when combined with a source of absolute critical chance. Just like with the Tenet Flux rifle, the Kuva Nucor puts out so much status that splitting up the damage type distribution is actually beneficial to it when using galvanized shot. For this reason, I'd suggest a magnetic progenitor. The magnetic proc will help with strongly shielded enemies, in addition to being a primer status, to go alongside the innate radiation and standard heat viral modding. Technically, impact with the hemorrhage mod gives you 5 status procs, but in my opinion though, the value of one more status type is lower than having the ability to weaken shields and health in one weapon. This is, after all, a video about all-rounder options. And so, there you have it. The damage type meta in Warframe is pretty heavily skewed to certain types at this time, and it means that the Toxin Progenitor is usually the best way to go for most Tenno. In limited cases, other types will be more beneficial, but such niche cases are just that, niche. The longer you look, the greater number of smaller exceptions you'll find after all. In any case, I hope this video helps you decide what's best for you in terms of a go-to all-round damage type. If you have found this video helpful or learned something new, make sure to give it a like and subscribe as well to catch more as it goes live. That's all from me for now though, so as always, accept meta, get toxin, and fight well, Tenno.